So last lecture we had done vertical financial statements. We are done with all this. Irina, I discussed the syllabus part with you, the paper pattern with you. Then I discussed with you why financial statements, what is the need for financial statements to companies. Okay, I had explained you what is a, you know, how is a vertical balance sheet and how is a vertical balance sheet derived. I had explained about notes to accounts, what does it mean in management accounting. Then I had told you a little bit just about cash flow and fund flow statement I had given. Okay, and I had said ki vertical revenue statements, vertical balance sheets and notes to accounts is there in your syllabus, whereas cash flow statements and fund flow statements you will be studying in the later part of the semesters. Okay. Then what else? Yeah, I had told you who are the users of vertical financial statements. I mean, to whom it is beneficial. It is beneficial to the investors, employees, lenders, your creditors, that is suppliers, your debtors, that is customers, the government and the public. Okay, we had also discussed about elements in financial statements, and I had also discussed this qualitative characteristics of financial statements. That is understanding the financial statement, relating the business related transactions with the financial statement, disclosure and non-disclosure I had discussed. Your accounting standard one is related to that. Then reliability, that is whenever you publish the financial statements in the business magazines or in the newspapers, it creates faith among the investors. And then comparability of the financial statements. I told you the current year financial statements can be compared with the past financial statements so that if there is any drawback in your business, you can overcome them. Or if it indicates higher profits to you, you can still further increase your profits. So it gives you both the ways, pros and cons, both it helps you to manage. Okay, then we had also discussed about this vertical balance sheet and how does it come from the equation A equal to L, that is asset equal to liability. And this is what we had discussed. Okay, A is application of funds, that is your asset side, and L is liability. In the new balance sheet, it is known as sources of funds. Okay, so as far as management accounting is concerned, you guys are no more going to remember the old format of balance sheet. Okay, just for my lecture, keep that old format of balance sheet aside, erase it. Okay, but for financial accounting, you require the old format. Okay, that is why I said only for my lecture you erase it. For my lecture, old balance sheet is not allowed. We will be doing the new balance sheet, that is a vertical format of balance sheet. Okay. Then I had discussed with you this fixed assets ka bifurcation. You guys had given me the examples, and then investments. How investments are categorized under this application of funds. We had studied. I had discussed this with you all. Application of funds. Okay, where money is applied in the business. It is applied in fixed assets. I had explained you the meaning of tangible assets, intangible assets. Then long-term investments, these are which investment. If I am a company, then say my company name is X Limited, and there is another company Y Limited. Okay, so okay, so there is a company Y Limited. This Y Limited, I have invested in Y Limited. Okay, my money I have invested in Y Limited, and Y Limited is giving me returns on the same. So for me, X Limited, it's an income. So I'm talking about that investment, long-term investment. Okay, next, working capital, and then in working capital, yeah, we had come to quick assets and non-quick assets. Okay. Let me discuss that also. Current assets, I had said it is a bifurcation of quick assets and non-quick assets. See this one. We are talking about this. We're talking about this current assets. Okay, current assets is what? Quick plus non-quick. Okay, quick plus non-quick. And then these are your quick assets. Quick assets means which can be readily be converted into cash. Okay. And what are non-quick? Which cannot be easily converted into cash. Matlab, it can be converted into cash, but it will take longer time. Say for example, if quick assets take a day or a two to get converted into cash, non-quick assets will take 1 or 2, 3 days more to be converted into cash. Okay. Say for example, I'll give you an example. Now see, this is a list of your current assets. Okay. So what is in the first list? What is in your first list? It is cash bank. Okay. What is in your next list? It is debtors. Then it is bills receivable. Then it is marketable securities, that is short-term investments. Okay, marketable securities means short-term investments. Then they come to outstanding income, then stock, then prepaid expenses, and these are advanced assets. So what are these? These are all current assets list. Okay, now how will you identify an exam whether it's a quick asset or whether it is a non-quick asset? Okay, now listen carefully to whatever I'm saying. Okay, I'll give you an example. Okay, I'll give you an example about this. Now, say I purchased a raw material for rupees 2 lakhs. Okay, so purchase of raw material for rupees 2 lakhs on credit. Okay, udhar pe liya, credit pe liya. Okay, then say the credit period is 4 months. Okay, that means after 4 months I have to pay to my supplier, the one who has given me raw material is my supplier. So after 4 months, I have to pay him money. How much money? I have to pay him 2 lakhs. Okay? Now, say for example, after 4 months, I am falling short with working capital. I am falling short with money. I am falling short with cash. Okay? So what am I going to do first? I will look into my cash bank account. Okay? I will look into the available cash with me. Okay? Say the available cash with me is zero. I don't have any cash in my pocket. Okay, that is called as available cash. That is zero. So I cannot pay this 2 lakhs rupees. Okay, then I will check into my bank account. I will see how much is there in my bank. Say my bank account is showing me 50,000. Okay, but how much I have to pay? I have to pay samne wala 2 lakhs rupees, but I have only 50,000 with me. Now see how the money will be paid. Okay. I'll show you the calculation how the money will be there. Okay, so 2 lakhs. What is my first option? My first option is cash balance, which I don't have. So I know ki mere paas rokda nahi hai, so I have no option of paying through cash. Next, I will look into the bank balance. Okay, bank balance is showing me 50,000 I can pay, so I will use 50. Next order. So this is the sequence of current asset. Okay, this is the sequence of liquidity of current asset. Next is what? Next is debtors. Okay, so next is debtors. Now what will I do? Okay, what will I do? I know my one debtor is of 5 lakhs. My one debtor is of 5 lakhs. Okay, so I will make a phone call to the debtor. Okay, I will make a phone call to the debtor, and the debtor. Just a minute, students. Got static, so I was just fixing the cam. Fine. So where was I? Yeah, I have to pay how much? I have to pay 2 lakhs. Correct. I don't have my cash. I don't have anything in my pocket. Zero. I cannot pay through that. My next option will be bank. I have in my bank account 50,000 rupees. I will pay through that. I know one of my debtors. I know my debtors have 5 lakhs rupees. Okay. So what will I do? I will call up. Say this 5 lakhs of debtors are divided into five people. First debtor, second debtor, third debtor, fourth debtor, fifth debtor. I have five debtors. Okay. Every debtor is with 1 lakh each. Okay, 1 lakh each. All the debtors. What will I do? I'll make a phone call to the first debtor. Okay. I will tell him, sir, I need immediate cash. I want to pay to one of my suppliers. He tells me, okay, ma'am, I will pay you by evening. Fine. So I have 1 lakh rupees with me. Okay. So 50 plus 1 lakh is 1 lakh 50. So I need another how much? 50. I give a call to the second debtor. I say, sir, I need urgent money. I have to pay to my supplier. Second debtor says, sorry, ma'am, I cannot pay you. I will pay you after 10 days. So he is gone. I don't have him an option because he's going to pay me after 10 days. Okay. Then I call to my third debtor. Okay. My third debtor tells me, yes, ma'am, I can pay you the money. Okay. I will pay you, but only 50,000 right now by today. I agree to him. I said, okay, fine, sir. You pay me 50. He is supposed to pay me 1 lakh, but I am taking from him 50. Why? Because right now he can pay me only 50. Balance 50, he will pay me later. So, mera kaam to ho gaya na. My work is done. 1 lakh plus 50 plus 50 is how much? 2 lakhs. Okay. This is called as liquidity. How fast you can convert your current asset into liquidity. That is money. Okay. That is called as quick asset. Understood, everyone? Acknowledge it in the chat box. How fast you can convert your current asset into cash is called as quick assets. Okay, acknowledge it in the chat box. Okay, fine, thanks. Thanks for the acknowledgement. Yeah, what happened? Vijay, you're saying my voice is breaking. Is it, students? Others can hear me clearly? Others can hear me clearly? Okay, others can hear me clearly. Vijay, then that means there is something wrong with your system. Others are able to hear me clearly. Okay. Thanks, students, for the acknowledgement. Okay, so clear about quick assets. Okay, so the faster I can convert anything into cash is quick assets, and the least I can convert. I'm not saying that non-quick assets are not convertible into cash. They are also convertible into cash, but they are not easily convertible into cash. They will take more time to be converted into cash. Okay, understood? So I will take you back to the example. So see, the highest liquid current asset is cash. Always remember, huh? This can be asked in your internal exams. Yeah. The highest liquid asset is cash. Then is debtors, then is bills receivables, then is marketable securities. Marketable securities means, students, I'll tell you the meaning. Marketable securities means short-term investments. Please make a note of all this. Short-term investments. Matlab, investments of less than 12 months. Because if investments are more than 12 months, it will become a fixed asset. It will become a long-term investment. Okay? And if it is an investment of less than 12 months, it is a current asset. Okay? Okay? So the highest liquid current asset is cash, then is debtors, then is bills receivable, then is marketable securities, then is outstanding income. Okay. And then the last three, stock, prepaid expense, and advance tax, they are least liquid. Least. I'm not saying they are not liquid. I'm using the word they are least liquid. Matlab, to convert them into cash, it takes a longer time. Okay. So they are least liquid. Just a minute, yeah. These three are non-quick assets. Please make a note of it. Stock, prepaid expense and advance tax are non-fixed assets. Okay, you have to remember it in this order because it is as per the liquidity. Julian Vijay, why are you giving your roll numbers right now? Did I tell you all to give the roll numbers in the chat box? Unless and until I don't give the instruction, don't do that. When I will tell you to put it in the chat box, that time only you will put it in the chat box. Okay? Is the concept of quick and non-quick clear? Quick assets, easily convertible into cash, non-quick asset, not easily converted into cash. But it doesn't mean it is not converted into cash. Okay, there is a thin line of difference between that. Vijay, there is still time for the lecture. I will say, that is my part. I will do that. Okay. Last 10 minutes when we started 11 o'clock, it is 11:40. Today we started at 11:50. The lecture started at 11:50. Okay, so there is still time. Okay, students, so I hope everyone has made a note of this. This is very important for sum solving. Next, same logic applies to liability. Okay, same logic applies to liability, quick liability and non-quick liability. Okay, so current liability is divided as quick liability and non-quick liability. Okay, what logic was applied for assets is applied for liability as well. So what is a quick liability? It is a liability which matures, matlab, which has to be paid, which matures in a very short period of time. Okay, a quick liability matures in a very short period of time, matlab, it has to be paid at the earliest. Then non-quick liability, opposite, which do not mature, matlab, can be paid later, but that doesn't mean it will not be paid. It will be paid, but will be given second preference. Okay. So this is the list of quick liability. This is a list of current liability, out of which creditors is highly quick liability. Matlab, first priority is you have to pay them. It means that first option, first priority, they have to be paid. Okay, next priority, bills payable should be paid. Okay, I hope you all have done piecemeal distribution in financial accounting. If not, then obviously in the later part there is a chapter called as piecemeal distribution in financial accounting, FMA. There is a chapter. So there also you will learn this, which current liability has to be paid first. That is called quick liability. Okay. So first is creditors. Like in quick asset, what was the most liquid asset? The most liquid asset was cash. Then was debtors. Like that. Creditors have the first option to be paid, then bills payable, then outstanding expenses, that is unpaid expenses are known as outstanding expenses, you can pay them later, then prepaid incomes, that is income paid in advance. Okay, 12 months ka rent you paid in 1 month. The whole year you have already paid, right? You should have paid monthly, but you had money, so you paid it for the whole year. Okay. Then bank overdraft, that is negative balance of cash in the bank. What is bank OD? When you don't have sufficient funds in your bank account as a businessman, bank gives you a provision. It gives you a, it gives you a helping hand that you can withdraw extra money. That is called as bank overdraft. But for that, bank definitely charges you. It does not give you free of cost. If they give you an OD facility, say for example, in your account you have 50,000 rupees, but you want to pay someone 60,000 rupees, but your bank account has only 50. The bank will give you an overdraft of 10,000 rupees, but not for free of cost. They will charge you some percentage of interest. Okay? Here, so there is only one non-quick liability, and that is bank OD. Right? So let me tell you, from year till year, this is quick liability. You have to remember the order on students. And this one is non-quick. There is only one. So as a student, what I used to do is, I used to remember only one non-quick liability. Then I know others are quick liability. Okay? Be smart. Do the other way. 1, 2, 3, 4 items. Remember, karne se acha, you remember one item of non-quick and the rest others are quick. Okay? Is it clear till here? Just acknowledge it in the chat box. Everyone, is it clear till here? Okay, fine, yeah. Thank you, students. Thank you for the acknowledgement. So, and all these things are very, very, very important for sum solving. Huh? Because sums may, they will not give you this is current asset, this is current liability. You have to identify on your own. Okay? They will give you a list, and from the list, you have to pick up and identify. Working capital, so is very easy. In a nutshell, I'll tell you what is a working capital. So working capital is, please note it down, is total current assets minus total current liability. You have to remember only this. Working capital is equal to total current assets minus total current liability. Working capital is equal to difference in current assets and current liability. Okay. Rest. Now this is something new. Okay. I'll take you back to your balance sheet, the new balance sheet, the new style of balance sheet. So now all this we have discussed, right? We have discussed about tangible assets. We have discussed about intangible assets. Long-term investments, working capital may, we have discussed about current liability, current assets, we have discussed about quick assets, we have discussed about non-quick, quick liability and non-quick. Okay, so our second part of the balance sheet is done, that is application of funds. Okay, now let us go up to the sources of funds. This also I have discussed, but let us come to the second part of this. This one. Reserves and surplus. Okay, just try to see. There are some new names for reserves and surplus. Okay, just see. I'll take you back to that. You should know the other names. Huh? I'm not telling you to mug up all, but you should know these names. What are reserves and surplus? They are nothing but they are my profits which I have kept aside. Okay, like how your mom must be doing. If your dad is earning a salary of 50,000 and he must be giving say 30,000 to mom to run the house, mom must definitely be keeping from that 30,000, 2,000 aside, and she must be running the house only in 28,000. Okay, and she will keep 2,000 aside as reserves. Okay, so that she can every month, if she saves like this out of the 30,000 which she's with dad is giving to her, she'll be able to create good reserves. Okay? Fine? And now you can start giving your attendance in the chat box. So see the names of different reserves under Companies Act 2013. Okay. So these are all names of the reserves. Capital Reserve, Capital Redemption Reserve, Securities Premium, General Reserve, Sinking Fund, Dividend Equalization Reserve, Worksmen Compensation Fund, Revaluation Reserve, Development Reserves, Other Reserves, and P&L Account Credit Balance is also a reserve. Okay, so these are the different names of reserves and surplus in Companies Act. Okay, so if any of the one word or any of the one terminology is used in exam, don't get scared. Don't think ma'am ne padhaya nahi hai. Okay, these are the different names of the reserves. Okay, so P&L account is also known as capital reserve, capital redemption reserve, securities premium, general reserve, sinking fund, dividend equalization reserve, worksman compensation fund, revaluation reserve, development reserves, other reserves, and P&L credit balance. Okay, am I clear about this? Am I clear? Just acknowledge it in the chat box. Okay, so there are 11 reserves with different names, but the bottom line is what? They are just different names for P&L account. That's it. Okay, these 11 names are nothing but the different names of P&L account. Okay, I'm just mentioning it here. Different names of P&L account. And then still have 8 minutes to go. Okay, and then this part I had discussed with you, fictitious assets. What are fictitious assets? They are those expenses which is paid by the businessman, which is not allowed under the Companies Act as well as under your Income Tax Act. They don't allow you to write it off in 1 year. Okay, so that assets that we are talking about, P&L account debit balance. Okay, and forfeited shares also I had discussed with you last lecture. What are forfeited shares? It is obviously profit for the company. That is why it is added. It is never a loss. Equity preference, we have done that. Then owed funds, we have done. Debenture loans, you all know. Loan from financial institutions and bank loan also, we have discussed already. Okay. So this completes our new style of balance sheet. Okay. Fine. And since you guys have already given me an acknowledgement every time, yes ma'am, we are wonderful, we are wonderful. So I assume to the best of my knowledge that you all have understood it. So let me give you a gist about what is after this. Okay, so let me take you back to the users part. We take you back here. Yeah, this one. Okay, so vertical financial statements mein, sorry, just a minute. Okay, vertical financial statements mein, okay, we are done with this. This is done. I've explained you this notes to accounts. And now today I will explain this. Vertical financial statements. This part. Vertical financial statement. Revenue statements, I mean. Okay, now what do you mean by this? Simple. It means new style of P&L account. I repeat. It means new style of P&L account. Okay. Now. as in my first lecture, I had already told you all the management accounting is a subject which even a non-commerce graduate takes. Okay, even he learns that subject. Okay, I told you engineers who do MBA, they learn this subject, management accounting. Okay, and then commerce graduates also, obviously they to by default have to learn it. Okay, so whether it is commerce or it is non-commerce background, now what they have done, they have compressed accounting. They have made accounting easy in such a way that even a layman can understand. Okay, like this one, asset equal to liability. Okay, if I explain this to an engineer, he will understand. And if I break up the equation and I explain it to him, he will definitely understand. Okay, that is what we did for balance sheet. Okay, now if I want to explain to a non-commerce background student that what is a P&L account, or what is a profit and loss account, or what do you mean by a revenue statement? Simple. I will just tell him, sir, do you know this formula? Selling price minus cost price is equal to profit. I will just explain him this. Selling price minus cost price is equal to profit. Okay, we all have been doing this formula since standard 3 or since standard 2, if I'm not wrong. In maths, this is there. Okay, selling price and cost price is equal to profit. Okay, so this, just a minute. Okay, so this profit is nothing but profit and loss account. This profit is nothing but vertical revenue statement. Okay. Understood, everyone? Is the formula clear to everyone? Just acknowledge it in the chat box. Is it clear to everyone? What did I say right now? Okay. So next lecture, we will see in detail, selling price and cost price and how you derive profit. Okay. So today I'm just giving you a gist. We are going to study tomorrow this formula in detail. Okay, so your vertical revenue statement will be drawn on the basis of this formula which I have written. Okay. Okay, now listen, what is selling price? The new word for selling price is now revenue. Okay, and the new word for cost price is total cost, also known as cost of sales. Cost of sales means sales at cost price. These are the different names, sales at cost price. And revenue means sales at selling price. Okay, is this clear? Acknowledge it in the chat box. Is the equation clear? Is the term clear? Okay, fine. Yeah, thank you students, thanks for the acknowledgement. Okay. So now next lecture onwards, I will not use the word selling price, I will use the word revenue, and you should know, okay, revenue means sales or selling price. I will not use the word cost price, I will use the word total cost, or I will use the word cost of sales. Okay, or I can even say sales at cost price. It means cost price. Okay, and the difference between the two is profit. Okay, now we still have 2 minutes. I'll explain you one small example. Okay, now I am manufacturing a pen. Okay, I'm manufacturing the pen for 20 rupees. Okay, और ये पेन बनाने का खर्चा आया मुझे 16 रुपीस. कैन एनीबडी टेल मी विच इज द कॉस्ट प्राइस एंड विच इज द सेलिंग प्राइस? विच इज द कॉस्ट प्राइस एंड विच इज द सेलिंग प्राइस इन द एग्जाम्पल? Cost price is 16. Okay, fine. Good, Dipesh. Yeah. And what is 20? What is that, 20 rupees? Okay, so Ankita and Dipesh give the right answer. Okay, fine. Great. So this is my cost price and this is my selling price. Okay. And 20 selling price minus cost price is profit. So 20 rupees minus 16 rupees is 4 rupees. Okay. So tomorrow when I have a lecture, okay, Shubhir and Kamlesh also give the right answer. Shamika also give the right answer. Okay. Very good student. Okay. So tomorrow, what are we going to study? We are going to study.